Story time. Housekeeping just knocked and I was shouting no thank you. I got up to quickly grab some clothes because I'm literally wearing nothing. And as I went to grab shorts, she just opened the door anyway. She just literally walked into my room as I was stark bollock naked. Even then, she was like, oh, I'm so sorry. And kept asking me questions like, you don't need anything, no, you're all good, you're all good, don't need anything, no towels. And I was like, please get out. Hi, so it's now 1:15 in the afternoon and I still haven't left the room. I did go get food, so that's a lie. But I'm back in the room. I have been feeling really weird this morning. I've been feeling really anxious all morning, like really anxious. And it's not because I'm out here on my own. I'm very much a me time kind of person usually. So I think I'm just a little bit overwhelmed. There's still quite a few things I wouldn't mind doing in the parks. I still need to pack. I've told people I will get them things. So I need to go to Disney Springs at some point and I've got all of this to do. But I had made plans with two other people to go to Halloween Horror Nights tonight. But based on how busy it was yesterday, if we're going, I need to do that early access thing, which means it's 3 p.m, which gives me an hour to get there. I've had an amazing holiday, I'm very lucky, and I've come 4 times this year, so I know it's stupid that I'm even feeling this way, but it's just the way my brain has decided it feels today. And it's making my body feel weird as a result. And because I'm on my own, I don't have somebody to kind of rant to and tell me to like snap out of it. So I'm just ranting to the camera, so I do apologise for this. I think I just need to stick to a plan. Right, I'm going to get over this because I'm going to message the others and just say go on without me. And then I'm going to tackle this. I think if I'm at least semi-packed or if it's all together, that'll make me feel less anxious about that whole situation. It's 3 o'clock, still in the room. I have now kind of packed. I've reduced it to stuff on the table. I've got my clothes there ready for tomorrow slash later on today. I've got a few things here. This is my like park stuff. Suitcase is pretty much packed. Carry-ons there. Other than that, just receipts and things. I've run myself a bath. I'm gonna quickly jump into it. It's not gonna be a long one, but I just thought I'd rather lie down and just take 5 minutes to officially de-stress rather than stand up and shower. I think that might help. So update again, I'm still in my room. This isn't anxiety based, don't worry. I was actually just in the bath because self-care and all of that. You didn't need that shot, I'm sorry. And then I got a message from Nate and Craig on Instagram. They got me a free ticket for Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party. They went to speak to guest services. Guest services were just like, oh, it's sold out. Let me just add him to the free booking for you. So I get to go to Mickey's Not So Scary. I am so sorry for my weird moment this morning. I do not know what came over me. I still feel it a little bit, but that is like overwhelmed me with like, it's just such a nice gesture, like it's crazy. And I'd only met these people this week, and the fact that they would do that for me is like ridiculous. I know we've spoken online for ages, but it's just all right, so now getting the bus to Magic Kingdom to meet the others. Didn't really have a costume for Mickey's Not So Scary, so I'm kind of makeshift Milo, but Milo now wears Vans and he stands Epcot. But yeah, so I'm bounding. Oh, and I've got a leather band and I'll show you the prop later. But yeah, so now I'm gonna get the bus to Magic Kingdom for Not So Scary. Meet Nate and Craig. Take it from there.
Yes, you need an extra wristband to stay in the park tonight.
Hey, I can't believe it. I'm so happy. So we're in, I'm so excited. Every goddamn time. But I picked up Nate and Craig, and this is Ryan.
Hello.
Oh, do you mind being on camera?
I'm fine.
Yeah, this is right. We're getting our bags. Yeah, thank you very much. Oh my god. Yes. I can't wait to tip you into here so many times.
What do you guys gotta say?
Trick or treat.
Trick or treat.
Thank you. We came in for food. They just reminded me that I, you know, should probably document stuff.
It's a sloppy burger. Was it a sloppy burger?
Sloppy Joe burger.
Sloppy Joe.
Yep.
Plant based,
yep. Anything else?
Sloppy, just like you.
She doesn't wait.
Headed for Seven Dwarfs. The characters, not the, not the ride.
Oh, don't you dare look back.
Great place, right? Ready?
dead face, and then the first person to laugh loses.
Love it. Okay, so we've just got a return time for Seven Dwarfs. It's a 45 minute wait, so we're going back at 7:50. It's because of the Das Party thing.
The Das Party! Disabled access system.
Say that again on camera for me.
Disabled access system. If you've got any form of cognitive problems, so if you're autistic, suffer with anxiety, you can also get it obviously for physical disability as well, like if you can't stand around waiting in line and stuff like that, which is pretty good. Because like most places like Universal pay you to sit in a wheelchair.
Which is what they said to me.
Wow. Was it nice having an educative experience on this channel? Because it doesn't often happen. You're welcome. Don't get used to it.
The apple on the side, stingy on the side.
Look at all the windows.
Do they do anything to you on the mansion?
Yes, the opposite is sitting outside.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Shut up. Shut your mouth.
Yeah, look!
Oh, I'm so excited. So, I have actually done one of these events before, but I do not remember anything like this. But look, I just saw some lightning, there's smoke. Yeah, look up in that window. And you can see things move. Oh, that's... I'm not even pointing the camera. Yeah, look up at that window. Up there. And stuff moves. Oh, this is so cool.
And I said, why, Renata, you look absolutely breathtakingly gorgeous. Because every time I complimented her, I really felt like I was complimenting myself. Which wins. Yeah, you get it.
We were going to Pirates, but then we were very much distracted by the, what was her name? But yeah, we were watching that lady talk, do her little show thing, and now it's time for the return time for Seven Dwarfs. Took me a very long time to get that information out, I'm sorry.
Bye. See you later. Bye.
Sam, how happy are you right now?
So, he kissed me so many times. We love an LGBT dwarf.
It's still raining, so we're going to take shelter in Pirates of the Caribbean. And as you'll be aware, I fit in very well on this ride, as I am now officially a pirate. So, just to let you know.
You get the key, I take you to the treasure, we spin it, we go happy.
Whoa, what the hell?
Oh, he seems sad.
Oh, that was me this morning.
Didn't want to alarm you.
Yes?
But I've just noticed that the village behind us is on fire. And I'd like to point out that I had almost nothing to do with it.
Happy Halloween.
Thank you very much. There you go. Bitch. Try it.
That got real creepy real fast.
Sorry,
Oh my god.
Happy Halloween!
He's a little bit fangirling right now.
So adorable. Ah!
That's terrifying.
Oh god. Oh my god. Oh my, okay.
Sure, it's actually
there. Just go. Just go. We literally follow the parade here. It's still going around.
See it here.
to life, see something strange.
Oh my! Shut up. Oh my God, look at it! Going for Galactic Hero. It's gonna happen. They're away. Are you ready to defend the galaxy, guys? When you know you're not getting Galactic Hero.
Galactic Hero. Twice.
It's all Photoshop.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Children.
Oh,
this isn't my war.
So drop in and join breakfast out. Share the fun.
Hi.
Have fun. We're gonna stay and watch you run in the rain.
Enjoy. Do you want to do space?
Yeah, let's go do space.
Let's go do space.
I think I broke the barrier of sound on that one.
What did you think?
I know you've done it a million times.
I love it. I knew you were screaming loud because I could hear you behind you.
yeah,
that sounds about right.
So we're hovering just in case they do some kind of show, because obviously the Sanderson show that they do is
cancelled
because it's like this. I'm a bit gutted because I have only seen it once, but I have seen it once, so I'm not like devastated about it. And I've had a really good night. I got none of that on camera. But they basically said it's cancelled and fired about 10 fireworks out.
They fired all of the fireworks at once.
That was cool. That was really cool. We love a Main Street rave. Was that real lightning?
I think that might have been real lightning.
Better than the Danger Sisters show.
To the left! Up! 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 Start! Side! 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 You gotta repeat it now, yeah!
This is amazing! I feel so much better than I did this morning. Sorry for the weirdness, not the greatest start to the vlog, but I've had a really good time. So my camera battery died last night, mid me filming a little close down from the night, so if there's any of that, you will have seen it, and now it's me, you've got me. It is 7:02 in the morning on my travel home day. The first time I think I've actually been up before 8 a.m. in a really long time. I am officially all packed and ready. I'm pretty much done. There's still a week left on the mug, so I'm gonna leave that somewhere in the resort for somebody to have. It's raining, which is fantastic. Don't really wanna travel back with wet shoes, so I think I might change into the ones that I was gonna throw out, and then I'll change into these for the flight. Done. So, it's time to say goodbye to the room. I usually do a room tour. So, let's do that. Table, chair, bin, shelves, drawer, TV, more shelf, closed fridge, open fridge, bed, tiny drawer, Bible, alarm, phone, remote, picture that I enjoyed a lot, curtain,
Iron. Ironing board. Safe. Safe key. Extra pillows. Hair dry. Ice bucket. Facial tissues. Cup, 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 cup. More bin. Toilet. Bath. Shower. Shower curtain. Shampoo. Conditioner. Body wash. Lots of used towels. Another bin. Full length mirror. But yeah, I really like these rooms. They're just simple and sweet. They're all you need in a room, really, for how much time you should spend at the resort. Mine has been a questionable amount of time, I won't lie. But yeah, I think I'm ready. So I'm now gonna head to Hollywood Studios. It's 7:09, hopefully I'll be there around sort of 7:30-ish. I need to buy a few things in Springs, meet some people for lunch, and then come back here for one. It's all doable.
I think that's everything. I think that's everything.
I think that's everything. Okay.
Bye, room.
Thank you, room 339. Okay, so just dropped my bags with bell services, and I think I just saw a Hollywood Studios bus, so I'm gonna run for that quickly now.
Thank you very much.
This park doesn't quite hit the same in the rain, I won't lie. At least this is making going home a lot easier. It's meant to be like this all week, apparently. So the good thing about the morning magic hours is everyone still seems to be going to Stinky Dog. Okay, but I am going to Tower of Terror.
Amid the glitz and the glitter of a bustling young movie town at the height of its golden age, the Hollywood Tower Hotel was a star in its own right.
Take special care to supervise your children. Thank you.
Screw it, let's do this. Slinky Dog dash in the rain. A 10 minute wait. Outstanding.
For Vermanescan Sentados, Las Manos, Brazos,
yeah. That's the whole key. But this camera isn't waterproof, so for obvious reasons I won't be filming on this one. Yep. That happened. That happened. So I've had a few different experiences today. I don't think I said. So after Tower of Terror, I went on to Rock and Roller Coaster. The music wasn't working, so it was a really weird experience. It was just like silence with the occasional sound effect. And then I've just done Slinky Dog Dash in the rain, which was a completely different experience. And I think I'm gonna head over to Galaxy's Edge. Wet. What I love about all of the like undercover rides and stuff is they keep asking you to take your ponchos off. So basically all that means is that anyone that was wearing a poncho now gets to sit in the dampness left behind by those that weren't wearing ponchos. Thanks.
Touch toilet.
So I have hopped into the single rider queue for Millennium Falcon. Again, still chucking it down. So pretty much a walk on. I haven't queued at all, and I'm a gunner.
Ah, a brand new flight crew. Good luck to you all. You might need it.
Go ahead and bring your flashlights to activate. Gunners, you can choose between automatic and manual targeting. Have a good
run. Alright.
Weapons are online. Light pilot, make the jump to life, Jerry.
Oh my God.
The star of Destroyer is collapsing! You retrieve two containers of coaxial! The star will be the resistance! You will earn the First Order and made Chewie proud!
I still love that ride. That's like my ninth time on it. Still obsessed.
Still raining. So I think I'm gonna try the Oi Oi part.
Okay, so I'm just sat in, I think it's docking bay cargo, something like that. I'm sure I'll write it on the screen. And they didn't have the Oi Oi Puff, so I went for the lava roll. The Oi Oi Puff is available from 10 a.m. When lunch starts. But look how cool this is. Okay, that was actually really good. It was like a cinnamon roll, but it had like an extra little kick to it. I can't put my finger on the taste, but it was good. Really good. But now I've got a couple of fast passes over in Magic Kingdom, so I'm gonna go and run over there and then Disney Springs for some shopping and meet with some other people for a drink. An antidepressant thing.
So on the way out, I just stopped to get one of the Diet Coke bottles. And I mean, she was changing the till and it was taking a while, so she just went, actually, that'll be on the cast member today. So it was free. Thank you. Bye, Galaxy's Edge.
I kind of stayed a little bit longer in Hollywood Studios than I necessarily wanted to, just because I was enjoying myself and everything was a walk-on. But that does mean I've been pushing it to then go to Magic Kingdom as well.
So I'm taking the Skyliner to Epcot. I'm going to do the Epcot experience.
And then I'm going to go to Disney Springs.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard the Disney Skyliner. At Disney Hollywood, we hope you enjoyed your visit to Hollywood today. Now wave goodbye to your adoring fans below.
It was really cute. So I obviously had my camera in my hand and the guy was like, oh, do you want to take pictures and record stuff? And I was like, oh, I'm easy, just whatever. And he was like, well, I'll give you the unwrapped one, just hold up one sec. And then he waited for the next one to come along and it doesn't have any characters on it, so the views are like not distorted. And then the girl behind me, the one I was supposed to go on was a Winnie the Pooh one, and then the girl behind me went, does that mean can I go on the Winnie the Pooh one? And he was like, yeah, sure, quick, go. And then she was like, oh my God, thank you so much. And then she was like, thank you to me. And I was like, it's okay, it wasn't me. But yeah, so we're all happy.
All right, so we need to transfer to go to Epcot, so this way. What are we gonna get this time? Yeah, I don't mind a wrapped one. I can go on this one, yeah, thank you. Oh my God.
So the nice cast member just went to ask me if I wanted an unwrapped one again, and I was like, no, I'll go on this one, because it's a Star Wars one with Chewie.
Get ready for how fast this is, it's terrifying.
Collect your belongings and watch your step. Thank you for flying.
It's this bit. Oh my God. Oh my God.
So I thought I might have to transfer again because it said Riviera and then Epcot. But it's all on the same line, you just stay on. So just waiting for the door to close again and then we're going to Epcot. This is definitely my favorite mode of transport here. It's just really cool. So cool. I know it's a bit wet, so it just naturally is colder today anyway, but then you do get a nice breeze. So I feel like, you know, it does keep you cool. However, the second it stops with no actual aircon, it's just gonna be hell.
Ladies and gentlemen, in just a few moments, we will be taking a scenic spin around the Skyliner turn station. Please remain seated. This station was designed for turning only.
Yeah.
I almost forgot about all this. Yay.
Good morning.
Morning.
How are you?
Good, thanks, you.
Good. Thank you, have
thank
a
you
day.
Thank you very much, you too. Epcot. Oh, I don't want to go. Oh my God. So first I'm going to do the Epcot experience. And then I'm gonna get a coaster set, because if you come four times or something like that as a pass holder, or maybe just in general, you can get coasters. And then I'm gonna get a impossible cottage pie, because that was really good the other day and I really liked it and I want it again. And this building is where they have the
Epcot experience, so let's go do that.
Welcome to a place that celebrates the magic of possibility and always has, right from the very beginning.
In fact, the heart of everything we'll be doing in Disney World will be our experimental prototype city of tomorrow.
That was really cool. I really liked that. It's got me really hyped for the new show that's coming. And then got a few little photo things afterwards, but this hasn't stopped. God damn it.
So I've got the coaster set, and then I got the mini pass holder magnet because I already have the Raimi one.
So it's a little bit wet, so I think I did get a fast pass for Soarin', but I think I'm just going to abandon that because I don't really care enough about Soarin'. It's great, don't come for me, but like, eh. I was going to grab an Impossible Cottage Pie, but I'm honestly not very hungry. So I think I'm just going to go to Disney Springs, and if I'm hungry by the time I'm there, I can eat with the others.
So because Jodie won't be here when Epcot Forever's on, I thought I'd get this as her souvenir. Aren't I nice? And also just spreading the Figment propaganda, to be honest.
Oh my god. It stopped raining. I was just so used to feeling it.
Oh my god, Pluto's doing a little meet and greet. Do I?
He's liking you.
Is on the phone first? Or the camera?
It's recording.
Okay, guys. Awesome. Oh.
Oh my god, I'm gonna cry, that was so cute. He licked me.
Bye Epcot.
It's starting to hit me that I'm going home now. That's it, no more Disney parks. Just Springs. And then my Magical Express. My Magical Express is at 1:25. Because for some reason, I booked the 5 whatever flight. I'm so tempted to just miss it and get an Uber and have another hour around.
Okay, so first off in Springs is the Marvel Superhero Headquarters, just because I told my friend I would get him a magnet for his fridge. So they just flat out didn't have any magnets, so I've gone for pins. He wanted a Captain America one and that was the only one they had. And then he just said he trusted my judgment on the coolest one, and that was the coolest pin I could find. And it's a Star-Lord, which I'm sure he'll love. And if not, I've got some more pins. Isn't that a universal thing from the 25th anniversary? Do you know what? Never mind.
Okay, so I'm in a very dangerous position right now. So, went for drinks with Pete and Keith. Any pictures and stuff? I didn't record anything, but any pictures and stuff I'll put in here. I had a really nice drink actually. It had like Dole Whip and Prosecco in it, so that was cool. However, they're avid flyers, and we just hypothetically were joking around about, because I'm so sad, we were just hypothetically joking around about staying for another week. They actually have a place at French Quarter with a spare bed, and I just looked on Skyscanner, and flights with Aer Lingus, so it would be one change via Dublin, from Orlando to Gatwick, which is where my car is parked, is £105. Now, assuming baggage would be 60 quid extra as well, maybe 100 or something, that's like only £200. And I have an annual pass, and I have a Halloween Horror Nights frequent flyer pass, so I wouldn't need to get any more tickets. I can't, but I could, and that's what's dangerous. Someone has just left work with no notice, which has kind of put everyone else in a position where they have to do other extra hours. So if it wasn't for that, I would be here for another week. I've had a nice holiday.
I'm going to be too spoiled if I end up staying another week, but just the fact that I could for so little is so dangerous to know. Okay, I'm taking it as a sign, because I spoke to Nate and Craig as well. They were here for a little bit, and they said I'd be an idiot if I did that. And then a goofy bus turned up to go to All Star, so I'm taking that as a sign that now is the right time to go home. It is. So close to just booking another week. So close.
We will be pulling into level 1. You proceed to level 3. That's where you'll find ticket counters, security screening, all departure gates, shopping, and restaurants.
So I'm now officially through security. Bags all dropped off. And just waiting for the flight. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the October 2019 series. I just really want to say thank you for everyone who's obviously messaged and things on Instagram, but like a huge thank you to everyone who's actually physically spent time with me. There were people that messaged me saying they'd like to say hello, and sometimes it just didn't work out, and I'm sorry for that, but overall I've had like an overwhelmingly like nice experience, and I just really appreciate it, so I just wanted to say thank you for that. This trip has been amazing. It's been so good. A solo trip that I haven't spent a single day on my own on. I'm really fortunate that I've been able to come as many times as I have. I think this is potentially most likely the last trip that I'll do with the annual pass. I will still find a way to gloat about once being a pass holder. And then just a massive thank you to Nate and Craig, especially from Marvel at the Magic, because they have been far more accommodating than they need to be. They did Moonlight Magic and the Halloween party thing. They went above and beyond, a bit like cast members. They just made such a huge impact on this holiday, especially towards the end when I was having my minor meltdown at the beginning of this video. But no, I really appreciate it. I'm not gonna cry. I did that a little bit earlier and at the end of the last series, and this video started on a low. So to end it on a high, let's have one last over the top, unnecessarily dramatic douchey montage.
Look at the state of me. Like breaking out in a rash.
That montage intro took me about 3 attempts to fill because the tano lady keeps going off. So, yeah. Thanks for watching.